Get in the car. There's no time to explain. You've been framed for a double homicide, and we've got to get you off the grid ASAP. You've had no time to grab any gear, but that's all right, because you've been carrying your pocket survival kit. A 7 by 2.5 centimeter aluminium capsule that contains all of the essentials to help you get by in the wild. We're talking fire-making materials, water gathering and purification, shelter building, navigation, disinfection, as well as a bunch of handy tools to cut, saw, fish trap and snare. All in a lightweight, convenient and portable capsule that can be worn around your neck, on your car keys, in your pocket, or up your arsehole. Contents include, for navigational purposes, we have a 1605 NATO button compass. A sturdy all brass and glass construction, this compass is dry, meaning that rather than being filled with fluid, it is instead filled with air, which results in no leaks or air bubbles that may disrupt accurate reads, even after years of being carried and janked around cross country. Two dots red tip for north and one dot for south. Its accuracy rivals even the full feature fluid compasses, though lacks a bezel for declination and so only really useful for general directions. But for something that can fit inside of a capsule, it's top tier, and that is enough to make a man erect, because button compasses are usually just notoriously god-awful. But not today, because no fluid, no problems. And additional bonus points for the direction dots being glow in the dark. Useful should you ever want to try your luck navigating in the pitch black dark. Because why not, eh? You gotta die sometime, right? Or perhaps not, because if you decide to hunker down before the sunset, then you'll need a fire. And for that, we have 5 stormproof matches and a strike face for on-demand fires, even in heavy winds and rain. As less time faffing around with natural tinders and friction fires means more time for you to kick back, relax, and contemplate how the fuck do you end up out here. And that's good for the soul. The strike face being separate is a huge point of failure though. Drop that on anything covered in a bright yellow leaf and you'll get proper banged. So for backup, we have a second striker stuck to the inside wall of the capsule. It's just as easy to strike, and its redundancy grants a huge peace of mind as long as it's kept on the opposite side of the matches to prevent any accidental ignitions, as that would be disastrous. For our knife, we have a 2.5-inch blade removed from a multi-tool. Short, sharp, and sweet. It is capable of cutting cordage, cloth, stripping bark, shaving wood strips, and processing tinders. So we can gather what we want to gather and cut what we want to cut. It's the dinky little blade that's going to take on the world. But this blade also doubles up as the striker for the ferrocerium rod. Our backup method of fire starting should we run out of matches. 5 millimeters thick and 4.5 centimeters long. It is as small as it can be while still being reasonably practical. Though it is still awkward. But using the bottom centimeter of our knife as the designated striker as the means of keeping the rest of the blade sharp and serviceable, with the right strike at the right angle, we get a usable shower of sparks that will ignite fine tinders. It is the little rod that could, and that is highly inspiring. But size matters, unfortunately. When it comes to ferro rods, the sparks aren't going to be all that impressive, especially if you've been previously spoiled by a 6-inch ferro rod. But in the end, it'll all come down to how fine you process your tinders. But natural tinders aren't always readily available. So to cover that base, we have 2 reels of a highly flammable synthetic tinder. The inner 8th strand of 550 fire cord. This highly fibrous and combustible material can be broken and ripped apart into a high surface area ball of fluff that will readily ignite and burn for a long time upon catching even the dimmest of sparks from a pathetically small ferro rod. And also, it can serve as a slow burning fuse for blowing out VC tunnels. Now, what about hydration? You can't just fit a bottle or a cup into a capsule, but what you can do is carry a rolled up 8x12cm plastic bag along with 6 chlorine dioxide water purification tablets. So you can head down to the stream and fill up the bag with water, which holds 200 milliliters on the dot. Insert 1/4 of a water purification tablet, as that is all that is required for such a volume. Let the tablet do its work to disinfect the water, and there you go. You're bacteria-free, mostly safe, drinkable water. Filtration is, of course, an issue. There is no real practical way of filtering out dirt or inert sediment, but those things are not what's likely to make you ill. It is the bacteria and the protozoa that you have to worry about. And those water purification tablets take care of that issue quite nicely. So, all things considered, it's not bad for something you can carry in your pocket. Not quite a fruity cocktail on a tropical island, but sure as hell preferable over a case of giardiasis. The main issue of having a plastic bag as your water vessel, however, is that one puncture and you're pretty much fucked. So, to counter that particular issue, we've lined the inside wall of the capsule with 4 inches of half-width duct tape, so we can plug them holes and smoke them bowls. A very suspicious looking set of gear overall, but a real A-class solution to the issue of dehydration. And for cordage, we have an aluminium spool with 4 meters of durable fishing line and 1 meter of brass wire wrapped around it. The best of both worlds. We have enough fishing line for a decent cast and a generous amount of square lashings for shelter poles, and enough brass wire for a good hearty garrote wire or wire snares, static fishing line, and additional lashings for shelter building. Maximum utility, we out here. But bonus style points, because not only does the spool fit absolutely flush within the capsule, but also the hole in the center perfectly accommodates the tang of the knife, so that the whole kit fits together, everything locks into place, it's as snug as a bug, and there are few things in life that are this perfect, and it's okay to get really excited about it. And to go along with the fishing line, we have 2 fish hooks. Perhaps to supplement the berry picking foraging game, each hook is covered with a flexible hard rubber sheath to prevent it from puncturing the quote-unquote water bladder when stowed away in the capsule. For an additional ultralight woodworking tool, we have the MVP 2-inch hacksaw blade. Because say you need a freshly fallen, strong green wooden pole. Then, rather than spending 100 calories trying to bend and break it back and forth and ending up with a really jagged split end, instead, you can just saw through it. Nice, clean cuts, easy pips, back to the existential crisis. But its main MVP feature is how it makes absolutely light work of making those deep V or square-shaped notches in wood, as those notches are required for so many things, such as primitive deadfall traps, friction fires, signal whistles, and ground stakes. Things that would be virtually impossible to do with a knife this small, but are made easy with a simple saw blade. So Mother Nature will provide the wood, and you, with your tiny 2-inch hacksaw blade, can rebuild the world. The hacksaw also doubles up as a backup striker for the ferrocerium rod, as those sharp teeth do quite well at shaving off metal for sparks. And when used in that capacity, it will almost certainly dull over time, and so we designate the tip of the saw to be used as the striker so that the rest of the saw remains sharp and functional for working with wood. And the last item that we've managed to stuff in there is a small vial of antiseptic liquid. Since even the smallest of cuts and wounds can turn infected quite fast while out in the sticks. Even on a good day, you're likely to get your legs torn up by brambles, so imagine the state of them after a day of panicking because you got lost 6 miles off the trail. But with this, we can disinfect and keep them clean, one less thing to worry about, spare oneself a spout of sepsis and a trip down A&E once you return home, and your future self will thank you. And that covers the contents of the Pocket Survival Kit, a variety of helpful tools that aid in fire making, water purification, navigation, first aid, and utility, in a container as small as a Swiss Army knife and as light as 70 grams. And that ain't bad for something you can fit in your pocket. Personally, I carry this on those easy pips, casual day hikes where not much is likely to go wrong, but so as not to tempt fate. On those day-long trips to the woods for video or photography-related things, and as a backup set of emergency spares as part of a larger full kit and carry for the multi-day, slightly more risky trips. Very handy indeed. And that's that. So, thank you for watching. I hope you found this video helpful and informative. And I will see you around, bros. Peace! Also, fun fact, I now have an Instagram, just in case you're interested in the outdoor-related things that I get up to in between those weekly uploads. Peace!